Welcome to Bloodbath and Beyond. Today we review Hatchet 3, Some Legends Never Die.
Written by Adam Green, directed by BJ McDonnell, and starring Kane Hodder, Danielle Harris, Carolyn Williams, Derek Mears, and Zach Galligan, Hatchet 3 takes place right after Hatchet 2. Mary Beth Dunstan has killed Victor Crowley. She scalps him and walks right into a police station and confesses her murder. Unfortunately, she is promptly arrested, and the local police department has to go investigate all of the murders that they assume Mary Beth committed when it was actually Victor Crowley. When they show up, Victor Crowley destroys them all. So what do we like?
I liked that this film went with the SWAT and the cops. They made Victor seem like an actual threat in this one, so it was cool, because like in the first one, it's just tourists. In the second one, it's the locals and the hunters. And in this one, where do you go from there? You bring in the SWAT.
I enjoyed the story as far as like Danielle Harris's storyline is concerned, because if somebody walked into a police headquarters with a fucking scalp covered in blood, you're going to jail. But it was fun to see the interactions between not only the cops, but we also have Carolyn Williams, who is a local blogger who is obsessed with Victor Crowley and the whole story. She goes to the police station to interrogate Danielle Harris and get to the bottom of this Victor Crowley case to see if he exists, and if he exists, how to defeat him.
Now, it wouldn't be a Hatchet series without Perry Shen. He's died in the first, he's died in the second, and he's back as a different character. And what's best about this one is they acknowledge it. And it's really funny.
We all look the same, right? It's hilarious.
I really liked kind of the evolution of Danielle Harris to this film, because now she's gone through some shit. You can see the intensity in her eyes while she's sitting in like her cell in the jail. And while she does spend a little too much time in the backseat of a cop car, you can tell that she's just waiting to get out, break free, and kill Victor Crowley.
I felt the realest character in this film was Corey Schneiderman, our like officer, our deputy, who is like bringing rocket launchers and like so much ammunition to fight Victor Crowley, because he knew what he was getting into.
Fuck this shit. Your ego is putting all of us in danger. Fucking fire me, I don't care, I'm leaving.
By this point in the series, you know what Victor Crowley's capable of, and he was the character that understood that.
And his counterpart was played by Derek Mears. He is basically the lead of the SWAT team. Derek Mears played Jason Voorhees in the Friday remake. And so it's pretty neat to see Kane Hodder as Victor Crowley, Kane Hodder also being Jason Voorhees, fighting Jason Voorhees. How cool is that? I just really like seeing Derek Mears. Derek Mears is like a really nice dude, but he can be such an asshole and a prick when he's on screen. And he brings this whole squadron to their death. And with all the deaths, just like the rest of the Hatchet series, we have over-the-top practical effects. Victor Crowley's just manhandling all of these cops, all of these paramedics, and all of these SWAT team members. Just a ton of people in uniform getting massacred. So with that, let's move on to our favorite kills. My favorite kill is Hamilton's death. This is just like a guy with an eye patch just kind of lurking around. He's in the wrong place at the wrong time. Victor Crowley comes up and slices his head in half, and a brain falls out.
My favorite kill is right off the bat at the beginning of the film, and that is Victor Crowley awakening on the third night. His body's in one of the rooms with the paramedic, Randy, played by Sean Whalen. Randy turns around, you get a jump scare, you get defibrillators on the skull of Randy, and you're seeing his whole head just getting fried. Victor Crowley opens it up and just finishes it with a big smash and a head explosion.
Now let's move on to our dislikes. My biggest issue with this film is the story. I really didn't like the story arc. I mean, I did like aspects of it, but I think that it lasted too long. Specifically, Danielle Harris's portion. She was definitely locked up for most of the movie. She didn't arrive at the swamps till about 50 minutes in of an hour and a half movie. And I just didn't like the jumping around.
This time we're having two separate story arcs. We're having the police dealing with Victor Crowley, and then we're having Danielle Harris dealing with stuff outside of the swamp. And it throws the pacing completely off.
When they did have like a ton of people getting killed in the swamp, it wasn't as effective as the previous films because we didn't learn any of the characters. So you don't care when they die. And when they die, it's basically just a slice here, a slice there, stomping on ahead of one guy and then moving on.
Now, being that this film is a trilogy, you would expect some closure by the end of this film. There was none. It ended with a cliffhanger, but we're not gonna get a fourth one, and we know we're not gonna get a fourth one. And to me, that's really disappointing, and it's kind of like a low blow almost.
Another downside for me was the cinematography. Now, while I've praised the series up until this point for it, this movie did something a little bit different. They had a different frame rate or a different shutter speed. If you guys have ever experienced watching a movie in 120 hertz, that's what this movie looks like. It took a lot of the realism of the camera moves out of the movie because there's no motion blur to the camera moving. Like, you can see everything as sharp as can be even when there's movement in the camera, and it's really frustrating to watch. Now it's time for our final thoughts and ratings. Hatchet 3 was the weakest of the Hatchet films. Unfortunately, I didn't really get involved with many of the characters, and so I didn't care when they died. I did like Danielle Harris as the lead. Unfortunately, she was underutilized because she was locked up for half the movie, and I wanted her to be set free. Another big thing that was missing from this film was the comedy that we're used to seeing throughout the Hatchet movies. They did have one or two, like, one-off jokes, but for the most part, this is a serious film, and it's strange because this is not a film to be taken seriously. So I'm gonna give this 3 unhospitable hosts out of 5.
And don't you try to steal nothing. I got eyes in the front of my head.
Why don't you just offer me some fried chicken and watermelon while you're at it?
I ain't got no food.
Hatchet 3 really should have been the strong point in the series, being that it was going to be the final film of the franchise. It just didn't have the story that we're used to, and it didn't have the charm that you would come to expect. I really didn't like the fact that it took place in two different locations that were cutting back and forth. When you're having that action and then 15 minutes of a car ride, it really doesn't get you in the mood. You have to, like, rebuild yourself to get back into the spirit that is Victor Crowley. It's still worth a watch, even though you don't get the ending that you're hoping for. But you do get a lot of kills, which is nice. So with that being said, I'm gonna give this 3.5 Danielle Harris shower scenes out of 5.
As always, thank you for watching. Like this video and comment below with your thoughts on Hatchet 3 and the Hatchet series in general. What's your favorite Hatchet movie? Mine's Hatchet 2. We like Hatchet 2. What do you guys think? Let us know. And if this is your first time here, make sure you subscribe to the channel to stay updated with everything Bloodbath and beyond.